You will undoubtedly have heard of the Kruger National Park, one of Africa's perennial attractions. But do you realize there are another 19 national parks in South Africa managed by the South African National Parks Organization? South Africa is a kaleidoscope of natural heritage. The magnificence of the country's natural beauty, wildlife and plant life offers any visitor an experience that will go unmatched in their travel history. The South African National Parks Organization is the leading conservation authority in the country and is justly renowned for the incredible natural heritage it conserves and manages in its system of parks across the country. A conservation agency, it operates with high research and management standards. 14 of the parks have overnight visitor facilities and a variety of good quality accommodation in rural bushveld, mountainous, desert, and coastal regions. This DVD features professional photography and detailed information about the most popular South African national parks for visitors, giving you a unique virtual tour of these beautiful havens of nature and tranquility. Kruger National Park. Synonymous with the ultimate African wildlife experience, no trip to South Africa, let alone the African continent, is complete without a visit to South Africa's biggest national park and game reserve. The famous Kruger National Park, established in 1898, is the real Africa, an area untouched by the encroachment of modern civilization and home to a vast multitude of rich diversity of animal life and habitat. In the northwestern corner of the country, spanning Mpumalanga and Limpopo provinces, the park extends north to south 350 kilometers along the Mozambican border from Zimbabwe. The park can also be reached by road via one of the 9 gates on the South African border. There are 3 airports providing access: at Bapalaborwa, Eastgate, and Kruger Mpumalanga International Airport near Nelspruit. The wildlife heritage and scenic splendor, as well as the excellent facilities you would expect for a national park, make Kruger one of South Africa's top destinations. There are 12 main rest camps in the park itself, offering visitors accommodation facilities ranging from smart guest houses to simple but comfortable, well-appointed cabins and safari campsites. The larger camps have dining facilities and a shop. For a more luxurious safari lifestyle, there's also 5 bushveld camps and several luxury lodges managed by the park authority. These provide more exclusive facilities, and a reservation is essential. There are also 7 privately managed concessions, essentially private game reserves within the park, which provide 5-star luxury accommodation and facilities. Kruger has the largest concentration of wild animals anywhere in the world. 150 species of mammal, over 500 bird species, and 380 types of tree live in this subtropical low-veld environment. Keep an eye out for the more elusive animals and birds during an early morning game drive, or take part in an evening safari where you can spot the mysterious nocturnal creatures of the bush, all in the natural tranquility of this vast, unspoiled reserve, where life is allowed to continue untainted by human intervention. Get up close to Africa's big game and wildlife and learn about the fascinating smaller details of the bush. A visit to Kruger is an exhilarating experience. Big game viewing on foot, accompanied by qualified professional rangers, tracking rhino, elephant, buffalo, and big cats. Other activities which can be booked include 4x4 and mountain bike trails. Marakele National Park. The place of sanctuary, the name of this park in the Tswana language, is 250 kilometers north of Johannesburg in Limpopo province. It is indeed a sanctuary for an impressive variety of wildlife due to its location in the intermediate region between the dry western and moister eastern regions of South Africa. This includes elephant, black and white rhino, leopard, cheetah, and the largest colony in the world of Cape vultures. The beautiful setting in the Waterberg Mountains defines Marikele Park. Hilly landscapes, deep wooded valleys, and rare trees. Accommodation within the park includes fully equipped safari tents, a bush camp of A-frame huts, and camping sites. Galahadi Transfrontier Park. Two frontiers, one vast park. Amid the ever-shifting sand dunes lies one of the last intact ecosystems on the continent. South Africa's Kalahari-Gemsbok Park shares an unfenced boundary with Botswana's Gemsbok National Park to form the great Galahadi Transfrontier Park. These are the distinctive Gemsbok. With its characteristic long horns and tri-colored hide, the Gemsbok is a desert animal, adapted to survive in regions without surface water. They're commonly found across arid regions of northern South Africa, Namibia, and Botswana. In a groundbreaking development in 1999, the governments of South Africa and Botswana allowed the establishment of the first cross-border reserve. Animals and visitors can pass freely between the two countries in a park where it straddles the border. The park covers a colossal area. This is 3.6 million hectares of conservation, encompassing sand dunes, Kalahari scrub, and arid savanna, and is one of the best opportunities for viewing wildlife in the world. Large herds of antelopes are present, as are their hunters, large carnivores. The park is also renowned for its birds of prey, weaver nests, and for meerkat and reptiles. The needs of visitors are well catered for at Galahadi's camps, but some can be reached only with an off-road 4x4 vehicle. This is Tweerivierum, the park's largest rest camp and administrative headquarters, situated on the southern boundary of the Galahadi Transfrontier Park on the banks of the dry Nosob riverbed. Tweerivierum has a shop, filling station, restaurant, swimming pool, and an information center, plus a good selection of accommodation options. Grootkolk is a desert camp made up of well-appointed wooden cabins. In the heart of the Kalahari Desert, Nosob comprises a guest house, cottage, chalets, and camping sites. The Kalahari Tent Camp features a luxury honeymoon desert tent, several large family tents, and 10 two-bed desert tents. Tents consist of a bedroom with fan, bathroom, and kitchen. Each tent is equipped and includes gas for hot water and cooking and solar lighting. Other facilities include a swimming pool and water hole. In a game drive in this arid, remote desert region, the raw beauty of the landscape comes to the fore. Ohrabis National Park. This spectacular cataract is the Ohrabis waterfall. If it's the unspoiled beauty of Africa that you're after, head for the Northern Cape, a stark land of the russet sands of the Kalahari Desert. 120 kilometers west of the town of Upington is the Ohrabis National Park, established in 1966. Ohrabis means the place of great noise, the name given by the Khoi people to these falls, where the Orange River, South Africa's largest, thunders its way through a ravine and plunges spectacularly 60 meters into a granite pool, part of a long gorge cut by the river into the rocky terrain. Other than the falls, there is much more to be seen and experienced in Ohrabis Park. The 50,000 hectare park is home to a variety of flora and fauna that can survive this inhospitable landscape. It is a place of klipspringer, bok, and cactus. Various exciting new eco-adventure packages are available to the visitor, such as self-drive game drives, night drives, the short Dasi Nature Trail, and the three-day Klipspringer hiking trail that takes the hiker from the plateau down into the depths of the gorge. Accommodation in Ohrabis Park includes fully equipped chalets, family cottages, and caravan and camping sites. The park also has a shop, restaurant, cafe, and swimming pools. Phalbos National Park. Deriving its name from the camphor bush dominant in the area, Phalbos is a unique mix of three ecosystems, a meeting zone of Karoo, Kalahari Thornveld, and Grassveld. Phalbos Park, established in 1986, is located in the alluvial diamond deposits of the Northern Cape along the Vaal River, where you can see endangered herbivores, black rhino, white rhino, buffalo, eland, giraffe, red hartebeest, as well as the largest herd of roan antelope. Birdwatching is also a main attraction at Faulbourse. Large birds of prey can be spotted here, fish eagles, martial eagles, as well as white-backed vultures. Accommodation in the park is of various kinds to suit all budgets and preferences, from rustic campsites to family cottages. Golden Gate Highlands National Park. The eastern border of the Free State overlooks the mountain kingdom of Lesotho and contains the province's most interesting landscapes. One of the visitor highlights is the Golden Gate Highlands National Park, another part of the Drakensberg mountain range. With beautiful sandstone mountains, the park is noted for its visual splendors. Distinctive rock formations, dark caves, and deep shelters, inviting exploration of these mysteries of nature in a secluded and tranquil setting. Golden Gate Park also contains some of South Africa's best ancient rock paintings. Although less of a wildlife destination, the park is home to Burchell zebras and some rare birds such as the bearded vulture. The park has two rest camps. Brandwach has full hotel and chalet facilities. Glen Rhiannon offers rondavel accommodation and camping. Mountain Zebra National Park. South Africa's Eastern Cape province, often bypassed by those heading for its more glamorous neighbor, the Western Cape, is one of the country's best-kept secrets. The biodiversity in this region is unmatched, offering a wealth of flora and fauna, including the Big Five. And the Cape Mountain Zebra, one of the rarest mammals in the world, threatened by extinction in the 1930s when the park was created to conserve the species, and it can be spotted here. This park is a gem. At Mountain Zebra National Park, you can enjoy some of the natural wonders of the Eastern Cape, abundant wildlife, game drives, hiking trails, and ancient San rock paintings in a malaria-free zone. Facilities include a restored 19th century frontier-style homestead and a four-bed family cottage, and there is a restaurant and a shop. Addo National Park. Around an hour's drive inland from Port Elizabeth is one of the country's best game reserves. Addo Park offers day, night, and sunset drives with some of South Africa's best elephant viewing. Often known as the Addo Elephant Park, this magnificently diverse national park offers a wide variety of game viewing, outdoor adventure, accommodation, and cultural experiences. It is the only area where Africa's Big Seven can be seen in one place. The incomparable thrill of observing a passing elephant herd is the stuff of dreams and legends. A malaria-free territory, Addo has the highest density of elephants anywhere on Earth, following a conservation program established in 1931 to save the Addo elephant from extinction. There are numerous other animals to see. In certain seasons, you will be able to see not only the Big Five, but also whales and great white sharks in one area, following the park's expansion to comprise both terrestrial and marine zones. There is a very wide range of accommodation styles and values at Addo, from ultra-luxurious lodges echoing the golden era of early 20th century safaris to modestly priced campsites. Thank you. Gora Elephant Camp. This is a private concession within Addo Park offering five-star luxury accommodation and excellent facilities and dining. Tsitsikamma National Park. The ancient San people called it the place of sparkling waters. At the very eastern edge of the magnificent garden route, Tsitsikamma National Park, a marine and forest reserve, lies between the rugged Indian Ocean coastline and the Tsitsikamma Mountains. A temperate high forest composed of ancient yellowwood, stinkwood, kamasi and other trees, plus distinctive Cape fynbos, rolls down to the Indian Ocean shores in an unspoilt carpet of green. And ancient rivers forge their path to the sea through deep rocky ravines. Take part in a tree canopy tour. An abundance of animals have made their home in this beautiful coastal forest, even the leopard. The heartland of the park stretches some 5 kilometers inland from the shore and contains a rich mix of intertidal life. Dolphins play in the waves of the Indian Ocean and whales visit the coast here. Tsitsikamma Forest, undoubtedly one of the most diverse and beautiful parks in South Africa, is the jewel of the garden route. Just east of Plettenberg Bay and situated within the Tsitsikamma National Park boundary, Nature's Valley holds visitors spellbound. This is the garden route's best-kept secret. Nature's Valley is a spectacular area surrounded on all sides by nature, with a pristine beach, a beautiful river lagoon, and the indigenous Tsitsikamma forest with its wildlife. Nature's Valley offers a myriad of activities: swimming, canoeing, hiking trails, cycling, bird and whale watching, diving, fishing, shark cage diving, sailing, cruising, paragliding, microlighting, and abseiling. In the area are a variety of resorts and tours, providing visitors with all the requirements for a perfect break. Knysna National Park. One of three national parks in the Garden Route on the Western Cape southern coast, 500 kilometers east of Cape Town, the region around Knysna is well known for its bird life, ecotourism, and water sports. The two striking sandstone cliffs, known as the Heads, guard the passage from the lagoon to the open sea, a narrow but extremely treacherous strip of water. A lush indigenous forest surrounds Knysna, where elephants used to roam. This is the Otoniqua Chuchu, the last working steam train in South Africa. A unique and fun way to see the Garden Route's coastal scenery. The area is popular for water sports, sailing, canoeing, swimming, snorkeling, diving, and water skiing. The Knysna National Lake Area National Park is home to the endangered Knysna seahorse, as well as a range of marine life and birds, a biodiversity supported by the combination of the estuary and marine lagoon location. There is no accommodation within the park itself, but historic Knysna town is a buzzing center of tourism with facilities to match all tastes and pockets. Wilderness National Park. One of the Garden Route's three national parks, and conveniently located on the N2 freeway, the Wilderness area with its series of lakes, indigenous forests, and abundant wetlands wildlife is a favorite destination for water sports, hikers, and nature lovers. There is an arrestingly beautiful long white sanded beach. Freshwater fishing draws many to this part of the Garden Route, as do canoeing, birdwatching, boating, mountain biking, and the endless uncrowded beaches. The park has two rest camps, as well as camping and caravan facilities on the banks of the Toe River. Bontebok National Park. Large herds of bontebok used to graze across the rolling plains of the Western Cape, thriving on its grasses and bushy succulents. Shot almost to extinction by colonists through the centuries, the species virtually died out in the early 19th century. Bontebok Park has been providing sanctuary to the threatened animal since 1931. And today, there's a population of a few hundred of these exquisitely colored buck. Situated conveniently near Swellendam along the N2 freeway, Bontebok Park is an ideal place to break your journey halfway between Cape Town and the Garden Route. The park is a lovely excursion for the whole family. Agulhas National Park. Cape Agulhas is the southernmost tip of Africa, 230 kilometers southeast of Cape Town, where the Western Cape falls into the sea. Beautiful in its bleak, lonely ruggedness, Agulhas is a place of nature in its glory. The shipwrecks are a reminder of the ferocity of the two ocean currents that merge here. The solitary limestone lighthouse, the second oldest in the country, built in 1848, warns ships of the Cape of Storms. It houses Africa's only lighthouse museum. You can see here the ancient tidal fish traps used by the Khoikhoi people. Rare marine birds can be spotted in Agulhas Park, as well as a huge diversity of plant life and limestone fynbos. West Coast National Park. Head north from the bustle of Cape Town for seaside towns, flowers, whales, and charming remoteness. The Cape's West Coast offers a getaway for those looking for a peaceful retreat. The West Coast National Park borders on the south of the Langebaan Lagoon, a region that is home to flamingos, penguins, and whales, a paradise for bird watchers with a population of some 60,000 water birds living around the lagoon. The national park is also the place where Eve's footprint was discovered, one of the earliest evidences of humans on Earth. Early spring, late August and September, is the best time to see the glorious carpet of flowers that cover this area. a display that makes an unforgettable experience. Discover pathways through the dense, pristine Cape Fynbos, leading to beautiful dunes, cliffs and beaches. Within the park area is accommodation in the form of a houseboat moored on the lagoon and two cottages. Other accommodation is available in the nearby picturesque holiday town of Langebaan. Cape Peninsula National Park. There are no other world cities that can boast being located within a national park, let alone a national park that contains two World Heritage sites. At the northern perimeter of the park stands the imposing Table Mountain, towering 1,086 meters above the city of Cape Town. The town, which is squeezed between landmark mountains and the ocean on a narrow strip of coastal plain. The scenery is wild and invigorating, and even though it's on the doorstep of South Africa's second largest urban area, there is an incredibly rich biodiversity of animal life and Cape Floral Kingdom plant life. Start by checking out the weather. If it's clear, take the Table Mountain cableway shown here from the station at Tafelberg Road to the top of Table Mountain. For the energetic, there's a network of 500 hiking trails across the park, offering all levels of terrain and degrees of toughness, and which are well worth exploring. But get a good map, advice from the tourist authorities or South African National Parks Organization. Walk along the relatively flat summit. Admire the dizzying views of Cape Town's metropolitan area and sip sundowners as the sun sets over the Atlantic. An experience not to be missed, as testified to by 800,000 visitors a year. It's an area for exploring over a day or longer. A fascinating blend of urban and natural environments. Cape Peninsula National Park has recently launched a guided 6-day, 6-night hike that starts in the heart of the city and ends at Cape Point. This is Cape Point. The funicular railway takes you to the very tip of the peninsula. The more energetic can walk the few hundred meters. Admire the spectacular views from the lighthouse at the end of the peninsula. Turbulent seas that have been perilous to mariners since the 15th century, when the Portuguese learned how to navigate around the Cape. Watch out for the baboons. You can drive to Cape Point. On the M4 via Simonstown and the M65, it's approximately 90 minutes from Cape Town. It is here with these beautiful images that Photos of Africa bids you adieu, hoping that we'll see you again soon in South Africa, a world in one country.